Okay, hello. Today I'm playing Gone. It's called Gone, just Gone, that's all it is. This is a game on the Super Nintendo, or rather. Yeah, wow. That's what you gotta look forward to, is a gorilla sniffing his finger after scratching his bum. Okay, so Gone was a manga about this little dinosaur guy. It's famous for having no dialogue, no sound effects, visually or anything. It's just the pictures and the art, and it's quite stylized and it looks really cool. Lots of dark, thick lines. Very easy to translate, obviously. So, yeah, he got this game apparently, mainly in Japan, even though it alike has very little text. Let's just get started. I don't know if stereo mono is really going to make a difference, but let's do it. So the title screen had music, but don't get used to it. By the way, I am playing this just because Did You Know Gaming did a video about Gone, so I didn't know about the game before that, so I was like, hey, we could play that. Hello, Gibbon. Welcome to stream. Good to see you. Gibbon and I have been having a very lively conversation about, about Donkey Kong stuff. We knew about Crazy Kong, which is a licensed port for the European market of Donkey Kong. But we didn't know that there were two or three handheld LCD games based on, based on Crazy Kong, even though they themselves don't actually seem to have much to do with it. Two of them are versions of this reskin of like a monster house thing. I forget already. But yeah, it's always fun discovering new games like that. Speaking of which, I've just discovered this game, so let's play it instead of talking about other ones. Yeah, it's fun. I don't know what to do. The boars ran away. Oh, there's one left. I think I have to beat up all the boars. Okay, I made that one run away. So can I move on? Oh, there we go. So this monkey was stealing my food at the start. The monkey must pay. So yeah, it's an interesting kind of game. No HUD. Little information given to the player. Let's just go through the life of this dinosaur. There's no music, only a sort of percussion in the background as you do things. I have a variety of moves, so B jumps, Y does a tail whip, and A does a headbutt. And if you press down an A in the air, you do a falling headbutt. Very reminiscent of, oh. Once he gets his head up running, he just sort of runs on his own. Yeah, reminiscent of BC Good or Bonk. Just something I played recently was a spin-off of that. So I'm pleased to see the headbutt, even though it works a little differently. Okay, so beat up all the animals. What do I do now? Oh, and if you just press down in midair, he does like a butt stomp thing, I think. Yep. Gon does get tired. I think Gon's male. I'm gonna use male pronouns. Oh, I can jump up here. Okay. Ah, the monkey! Curse you, monkey. So, from what I heard on that video, Gon doesn't really have health. He's sort of an invincible, he's kind of a gag character, so he can't be hurt. But if he continually gets annoyed and gets too angry, he'll destroy the earth, and hopefully we see that over the course of the game. Let the monkey go. Whoop. Oh, that's right. I do have a extra jumping abilities I haven't had to use yet. The other thing is that Gon has kind of a Castlevania jump, where once he starts jumping, You can't adjust his momentum in midair unless you do a double jump. Well, you know, breaking physics obviously with a double jump. He can also do this flappy jump thing like this. A bit like a Yoshi, but even better. Gon is just baby Yoshi, isn't he? Okay, found a cave. Gonna get my food back from that monkey. This is like kind of like what the manga's like too. Whoa! A Gon head. I fell down. What happened? That's the. I wasn't supposed to fall down. There we go. Gon continues being angry in space. Continue three. Does that mean I only have three continues? Oh no, back from here. Well, that's the way it has to be. So this is Gon. I have seen the manga before in my local comic shop. They have a few volumes, and whenever I'm there, I like to just go up and have a little flick through it. I haven't bought an issue or volume or whatever. But yeah, I really like the art style and how it manages to tell a story completely wordlessly. Oh, I didn't know that. That works pretty well. Let's try the butt stomp. That doesn't seem that effective. That was two balls stacked up there. Nah, monkey! Oh! That crafty monkey hit me in midair. Okay. Of course, that's not where I originally know Gon from. Most people probably know Gon from his cameo appearance in Tekken 3. And that's certainly where I first saw him. Oops. That's amusing. Oh, maybe I can't get through until I beat all the animals. Even though I did chase off the monkey. Are there two paths? Maybe there's two paths, because I beat the rhino up there. Alright, let's see what happens if I go this path after beating up the boars. Seems like all animals have an invisible health bar. Okay, so we'll save here. I know, it's still close. Now we'll go back up. Oh yeah, this rhino. Gon's very expressive with his large head. I believe the concept is that he's a dinosaur who survived past the dinosaur age. And is just basically trying to make his way in the world in the age of mammals and fighting other animals and beating them up. Alright, so we're going to go in here. See where that takes us. Oh, that's chasing the monkey. Alright, let's go the other way, because that head might be a bonus thing, and I actually missed getting it, so we'll go check out what that is. Uh-oh. Okay, whew. He has to recover after doing that flat move. Whoops! Okay, good. Gibbon is looking into the LCD game. Yeah, we discovered, oh, hello, Danger Mouse. Yes, she agrees that Gon is cute. I promised her a cute dinosaur. Okay, that was it. That's what the bonus was. Hope you're satisfied. Yeah, so Gon's a cute little dinosaur with a big head. He's the last surviving dinosaur, and he's contending with other animals. This monkey stole his food. That's basically all you know at this point. Oh no! Oh geez. It's my least favorite thing of the 16-bit era is pseudo 3D mode 7 stages. Hooray. Okay, so it looks like I have just a headbutt with Y and a jump. So headbutt has switched buttons. Now I catch up with this monkey. Can I go faster? I'm holding up. Doesn't seem to help. I'll just have to try and not run into those puddles. Yeah, so Gibbon and I were looking at these LCD games. Because the company, was it Falcon, got the license to distribute Donkey Kong arcade machines in Europe. They rebranded it to Crazy Kong and changed a few things with assets in the game. And they also ported it to the ZX Spectrum and Commodore 64. All of that is totally legal and authorized by Nintendo. I saw a post today on a popular blog claiming that Crazy Kong was an unauthorized or unlicensed bootleg, which is just not true. Things pop up so quickly, it's difficult to avoid them. Okay. This is probably not as annoying as Super Star Wars, but yeah. So off the back of that, obviously in Japan and America, Nintendo released Game & Watch titles based on Donkey Kong. And in America, Coleco even made some of their own that are separate. And there's a surprisingly large amount of them. You can check it out at DK Vine's Honorable Mentions feature if it's actually up at the moment. I'm not sure. The page was a little bit broken last time I checked, but all my research about it is there. So just in the same way, Falcon commissioned LCD game handheld versions of Crazy Kong. Okay, that's not actually true. What they did was they took an LCD game that had been made by, was it Tomy in Japan? And without changing any in-game assets at all, and by in-game assets I mean like the LCD sprite screen thing, they just put a gorilla on the packaging and said, this is Crazy Kong. The actual game is like a boy in a haunted mansion fighting off a vampire and a Frankenstein monster and a mummy and a skeleton, and there is no gorilla in the game. This game, there's two versions of it, a widescreen version and a non-widescreen version. They're pretty much the same game, just slightly altered layout of the level. We did find a third game by the same company, and by the way, all these LCD ports were outsourced to, what were they called, Grandstand. So Grandstand have these two Crazy Kong games that are just this Monster House game. But there's a third game, also called Crazy Kong, that we've just seen one picture of and there's no other information about it, and we can't really tell what is going on in the game itself. So this isn't... I was just about to say I'm making no progress, but then the monkey popped up out of nowhere. Yeah, so we were trying to find more about this third game. By the way, the widescreen version is spelled Crazy Kong with two K's. The original version spells crazy with a C. Come on, monkey. Stupid monkey. Ah, dang it. Man, this is hard. Yes. So Gibbon is clarifying about the Crazy Kong arcade release. It's not like a port. They actually just sort of replicated the gameplay of Donkey Kong by modifying another game called Crazy Climber. And yeah, they made it themselves from the ground up, he says, even if it is based on Crazy Climber. Possibly due to code licensing issues, which have been a hassle in the back, behind the scenes for Nintendo since they got another company, Ikegami Tsushinki, to create the hardware and code the Donkey Kong game. Like, the license for that original game is speculated to be part-owned by that company, which is how which is why Nintendo themselves can't re-release it. And Ikegami were also contracted by Sega to make Crazy Kong. No, not Crazy Kong. What was the other one? Kongo Bongo? I don't know. Gibbon knows more about this than me. He's the expert. Ah, I was so close there. All right, next time I'm on its tail, I'm going to save, and then we'll get this stage over with. This is my problem with these Mode 7 things. All the gameplay is happening within, like, a tiny window that's, like, 1/5 of the screen, when things just pop up and very rapidly approach you. Come on. This is so boring. Okay, Gibbon's correcting me. There are some Crazy Kong LCDs that are just rebranded DK LCDs, Donkey Kong LCDs, but not the Game & Watch ones. So, like, the Coleco ones? Maybe? I don't know. But those ones are from a company called Grandstand, and yeah, they're rebranded. And yeah, it's Congo Bongo for Sega. Was that intended to be a Donkey Kong game, and then they couldn't get the Donkey Kong name? But like, Ikigami still made them a game. Like, the creators of Donkey Kong, Ikigami, made Sega a game about a gorilla called Congo Bongo. And they wanted to do another one where Donkey Kong was a car park attendant or something. It's weird. That one didn't happen. Yeah. We've been down this rabbit hole all afternoon. It's been really interesting. Okay. Save. Alright, we're gonna catch this monkey, damn it. Get back here. Yes. It's been good talking about Donkey Kong stuff while this level is going on tediously. Headbutting seems to slow me down. I just don't know how to go faster to catch up to it. Does jumping speed me up? So there's a little bit of music here. Oh! What am I doing wrong? Yes! 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 Okay, I win. Okay. So yeah, as you can tell, the licensing history of Donkey Kong is a little complicated. And we're discovering more about it all the time, apparently. Whoa! An acrobatic monkey. Rawr. Oh! I got too angry. And I destroyed the Earth. It's a very Arale thing to do. Yes, thank you. See, we're down to two continues now. So I'll use that one because I don't remember if I saved after catching the monkey. Oh no, we're back here. I better load. Okay, we're back here. Sorry, I will save this time. I promise. Oh! I saved right when I was really low on health. So yeah, Gon never dies, the Earth dies, and Gon survives. Gibbon's setting me straight. Okay, originally it was believed that Congo Bongo was just Sega trying to compete with DK and hiring the same people to do it. But recently it was discovered that Nintendo had seemingly actually contracted Sega to make a DK arcade game around the same time, a deal which fell through when Sega got sold to a different owner. So it's easy to speculate that Congo Bongo grew out of that failed DK Sega game in some way. Is that the parking attendant one, or was that a different thing? Yes, we're doing better this time. Just catch up to the monkey, don't let it throw the rocks. No, don't throw the rocks! Yes! We beat that thieving monkey. Yeah, I mean, the problem is, all the people involved in this deal and this game are very old Japanese businessmen at this point, so getting the truth might be very difficult for us. Similarly, I don't know how it is that Gon appeared in Tekken 3. I don't know how that deal happened, whether the Tekken guy was friends with the manga guy or something. What's going on? I assume I'm supposed to be getting the fruit in some way. Maybe I hit the monkey? Nope. Give me the fruit. What? I don't understand. I didn't comprehend the bonus stage at all. Oh. There's a score. No, that's the password for this level. And apparently their statues have gone. I didn't know that. Nice happy dance. Yes. That's pretty great. I like the happy dance. Okay, maybe I unlock that bonus stage because I picked up the little gone head in that secret area. Ooh. Elephant. Whoa. I didn't know elephants could do that. Yep, the parking attendant one is the one Gibbon was talking about. What a strange and convoluted history Donkey Kong has. And because there are so many of these, like, semi-licensed ports and stuff. I say semi-licensed, like, Kongo Bongo is not, but Crazy Kong is. That gives Gibbon a lot to cover on his arcade DK fan site. DKGerda.com. Check it out today, kids. Hey, here's another head. Yeah. Okay. So I want to avoid the shark in the water as much as I can. Oh, wait. Maybe I need to fight it. I think Gon's objective is just to fight all the animals that he meets. Okay. Let's see. And he doesn't need to breathe, apparently. I think we're faster at swimming. Okay, I can tap, jump, and hold a direction to swim. Okay. Shark! Take that! Ah! Okay. Oh! Oh no! Oh no. Fight, fight! Don't go down like that, Gone. Will I escape this? I'm jamming all the buttons, dudes. I don't know what to do. What's working? What's making the shark do that? Pressing buttons? No? Okay, I just cycled. Great. So I'm cycling up, down, left, right, kind of in a circle on the control pad to do that. Is it just me or have I gone more red than before? No, it's just the water layer. I wonder if it looked like that on original hardware. Sometimes emulators don't handle transparency very well. Or effects like that. Let alone the differences between playing on a CRT and playing on an LCD. Okay, I beat the sharks, I think. Nope. Not quite. I wonder if my health or, like, annoyance level is, like, something that's global in the whole level, or... Oh, dang it, shark! Yeah, I guess they just can't digest him. They can't chew him up. His skin is too tough. So he just sort of sits in their gullet, and then he fights his way out. Okay. Is that when he's left? No! Come on, shark! Whoa! Is the water level rising? What happened? Nope, just normal waves. Okay. Save there. Let's go back to the door and see if it's opened. Yeah, Gibbon says, it's amazing that I'm still finding new games to cover. You'd think this would have been a quick site to set up, but no. New games all the time. Yeah, it's exciting in a way, but also a lot of work for you. What? I don't know what to do. Is there another button? X doesn't do anything, by the way. Oh! If I hit both shoulder buttons at the same time, he doesn't bite. Did not know that. I wonder if there's another secret combination move. He just bounce on his own head. Oh! Okay, I can do that. Ah, it seems I have to uncover a hidden path. What does this remind me of? Kirby's Adventure? can't get through here. What gives? Yes, the fierce biting. I don't remember if he could do that in Tekken 3. I haven't talked much about Tekken 3 yet, but yeah, I guess most people would know Gon from there because, like, this never left Japan. The manga has been released here, obviously. I saw it in the shop. But I don't know how popular it is. Tekken, obviously very popular. Tekken 3 on the PlayStation 1. Gon was a secret character that you unlock through the Tekken Bowl minigame. I'm kind of stumped here, actually. Maybe there's another... Okay. It's right up against the bottom of the screen. I couldn't... anyway. Cool. Yeah, so Gon... he was kind of annoying to play against because he's so short. And in the game, he only comes up to, like, the waist of any other human character. Or indeed, kangaroo or bear character. Also in that game. He was like a special guest character, I guess. He hasn't really shown up in any other Tekken games. But I gotta hit the floor over here. I keep forgetting about the floor. There we go. Bats! I'll eat the bats. That scared it off. Pretty cool. That was fun. Let's see. Yeah, so Tekken, Gon was basically the odd job of Tekken, where he was so short that a lot of attacks would pass over him. So if you wanted to be cheap, you could use him against your friends. The way I played Tekken was at university. A friend of mine had it on an emulator on a laptop, and between classes, we would have a whole bunch of people gathered around his laptop, just watching. We didn't often play versus because it was difficult with the keyboard. we did sometimes, but what we did most of the time was just take turns between us, between this group of people, playing the single play mode. And he had all the characters unlocked, which was cool. Well, maybe not the doctor guy, I don't remember that. But, yeah, good memories. Haven't played any other Tekken game since, but I do remember that fondly. Of course, there's this sort of CG animated, like, FMV sequence at the end, once you beat the story mode, as, you know, any particular character. It just did a Jaws thing. Did you guys hear that? Like, the opening chord of the Jaws theme played when the sharks were there. Well, let's do the bite. Oh, that works pretty well. I think the rock landed on me and hurt me. Ah. And yeah, so when you beat the game, it's Gon, you get this cinematic that's, you know, a lot like the manga, actually. Just sort of a day in the life of Gon. He wakes up, he chases some animals, he gets roughed around and knocked away into the ocean, and then he rides a dolphin, and then... How does it work? It's pretty crazy. He rides a... Ooh, hello, bird. I'm going to eat you. Yeah, so the thing about Gon's cinematic is it loops. You get through it and he falls into... I think it starts with him coming out of the ocean, and then at the end he falls into the ocean, is how it works. Ah, come on, bird. Come on, bird. I could fly too, you know. I don't remember if he did that in Tekken. He also had a fireball attack in Tekken, which I don't think he does in the manga. He just spits it out of his mouth. Well, let's continue on and see if the door will not open for us without the death of that bird. Nope, it's open. Cool. Now, Danger Mouse is informing me about a game that she played that did a similar thing with a destructible environment, possibly a mining game. She says, I'm guessing that was the style of the time to reveal secret paths in land. I've certainly seen it a few times. Rayman Legends comes to mind, but that's a bit different. It's done with a touchscreen. Yoshi's Island does it, for sure. It's not a core mechanic, but you get the sponge blocks, sponge block square pants, that you can destroy with your head, with a ground pound, or with eggs, and that carries through into other Yoshi's Island games too. Rah! Oh, nope, too mad. Too mad, Earth dies. Oh yes, Gibbon mentions Dig Dug, that's a good example. What happens when you do run out of continues? Man, this elephant. It's mean. Oh, what do? Let me fly over it. Nope, can't do that. Let's get up high. No, okay, it seems to stop me if I get too close or like that. Oh, yeah, that's it. Gotta be careful with Gon, gotta treat him kind. That might be, yeah, okay, so it looks like he'll do his big head thing like 3 times. And Bonk does this very similar thing, actually. I wonder how much, you know, they're obviously made by 2 different companies, but I don't know, maybe it's just a kind of a trope of cartoonish characters. So yeah, this game is made by Tozei, a Japanese company that does a lot of outsourcing. It's kind of a silent partner kind of thing. It develops a lot of games for other companies without really being too... how do I put this? They just sort of make the games and don't make a big deal about it, you know? But usually working for other companies, they've only made their own game for themselves a few times. I think Starfy, the legendary Starfy, well, there's like 5 games in the series, but yeah, that's one of theirs that they created. They also did Super Princess Peach on the DS. Good game, play it. Whereas Bonk, obviously made by the company called Red for, what's the company that makes the PC Engine? I don't remember. That's weird. Even Metroid 2 and Super had a bit of it, says Gibbon. Correct, yes. I forgot about that, but I definitely remember in Metroid 2 going through the caverns that have, like, this awful respawning, soft ground that you shoot through, and then Metroids appear in it. Okay, let's just do a hit and run tactic. Go in, do an attack, go back. I do have a dash move, by the way. I run faster doing that, but then it's hard to stop as well. Okay, good. When it's going rearing up, then I can come in for an attack, but not when it's got its trunk down. Strategy, man. I like how everything in this game is like, you know, naturalistic animals and environments too. And yet, it's still kind of, you know, it's still a good game. It's tense, it's exciting, it's fun. But I think part of that, part of its style is how the main character contrasts against all the real animals around with his big head, big eyes, and outrageous attitude. Which was part of the original manga, I suppose. But yeah, this game does it well too. I'm reminded of Tokyo Jungle, mainly because I'm just playing it at the moment. that's a game where you play as an animal and you fight other animals. the similarities pretty much end there, but I'm playing it at the moment, so I'm thinking about it a lot. It's quite good. We start as a Pomeranian in the post-apocalyptic streets of Tokyo, where nature has reclaimed the city from humans. The humans are all gone, and like escaped pets and zoo animals and livestock have escaped and are now sort of trying to survive in the city and holding territory and just looking for food. And you can play as a whole bunch of different animals trying to get by in Tokyo. What's going on? Am I winning or not? See, the downside of having no HUD is having no health bar for your enemy. I don't know if what I'm doing is correct, or how much I should be doing it, or if I should follow up the attack with something else, maybe? Or I just have to do this a lot of times. Let's try a bite. Nope. I like doing the tail whip attack because it's quick, and comes out quick, and then I can escape. But I don't know if it's the best tactic here. Okay, it can eject me from its hitbox like that. This is tough, man. Dang. What do I do? I'm one hit from death. Gonna try and get it on the back foot and then see if I can follow up. Ah. Ah, no. Okay, so I can hit it when its trunk is down, but not if it's in the midst of raising it like that. That's an attack. And that hurts me. I'm trying to do a jump and attack. That seems to work. Okay, I'll save there. I wonder if I recover my annoyance invisible stat. Aha! Yes! Midair dance. Excellent. Take that, elephant. I don't know what you did to me, but I beat you up. Sounds a bit like Wario, actually, in that dynamic where he can't be killed, he can't be hurt by anything, but, you know, he might be inconvenienced by things that he comes across. In this case, he destroys the Earth if he gets too annoyed by things. Wario doesn't exactly do that, but, okay. Cat ate the bird. And Gon is angry about that. Maybe the bird was his friend. Aw, poor bird. But that's nature. Oh! Oh, that's cool. Oh no. I love Gon, he's cool. Ooh! Waterfalls. Wah, take that. Yeah. Oh! Oh! Mean cat! Well, I attacked it, so. Yes, I knocked it down the waterfall. Ah! No! No! Man, this cat's beating me up. Yes! Okay, it ran off. Gotta get a run going and then double jump. Works pretty well. And yes, I approve of any game that has a double jump. Snakes! This is bad. I don't think I'm doing anything to these snakes. Got a nice little soundtrack though. Okay, I feel like there's an invisible health bar. Oh no, oh no, oh no, oh no, 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 no. Ugh, didn't make it. Oh, there's a lower level. I feel like the snake cave might have had something cool in it, maybe. Let's try it. Okay, so there was a question that I had about somebody had transcribed the manual of Monster Panic. Monster Panic is the name of the... Oh, the cave was right there. I could have just gone in it instead of attacking the snakes. So Monster Panic was the LCD handheld game that was rebranded as Crazy Kong with no changes to gameplay. Oh, I'm back here. Ah, okay. So I do want to go down. I guess I'm chasing the cat across these different environments. That's interesting. Yeah, so the game is called Monster Panic. Come out, cat, where are you? And yeah, someone had transcribed the manual of it, and it claimed that there was a Bigfoot. But I couldn't see it anywhere in a video that I saw. And you know how in LCD games you can sort of see the sprites that are there, even if they're not currently lit up, like, because there's a shadow. Kind of like how you can see all the little lines on a calculator's digit thingy, even if they're not displaying a number. Anyway, I didn't think that I could see a Bigfoot there, but I guess maybe they just, I don't know. I couldn't see the shadows well enough, I think. Or I was looking at it the wrong way. Something like that. Anyway, point is, Gibbon says he's found a video that shows the Bigfoot. If you hang around too long at the start, it kicks you out into the Frankenstein monster arms. Into the Frankenstein's monster's arms. Yes, pluralization. What's going on? It's a confusing mess. All the caves lead to the snake cave. And then I just get hurt by snakes. I don't know where that cat ended up. I also don't know which of my attacks are more effective, if they have different damage values. So that leads to snakes. That leads to snakes. Everybody gets snakes. I wish we could have this little nice drumbeat of him running continue longer. Where's the cat? Ah. Stupid cave. Is there anything else over here? No. Back in we go. Gibbon's drawing a connection between this Bigfoot kicking you and DK booting Mario from off screen in the ending of DK Jr. When Jr. rescues Papa from the cage and then Mario chases after them. DK kicks him from off screen. Senior, I should say. Okay, let's try along here at the bottom. I don't know if I did that before. Actually, I think I did, but anyway. Oh, boy, oh boy, oh. Okay, so if I go in here, this is like, ooh, this is bad. This reminds me of a room in, Castlevania Rondo of Blood, I believe. All roads lead to snakes. Ah, snakes! So the background is sped up with a drum beat, which I think means I'm getting in angry mode. So that must be a permanent, like, health thing that doesn't recover. Which is bad because I'm no closer to finding the snake, the cat, and I've only got one continue left. Oh, I fell down. Should we see what happens? No! Oh, now I have two continues. Do I earn another one? I won't need to continue, I'll just load. Although, I have lost the cat, so I don't really know how to. Maybe I could destroy some walls in the snake cave. Okay, there's four exits from here, right? That one definitely leads to the snake cave. Bottom left one leads to the snake cave. And the bottom right one leads to the bottom left. Huh. Is the snake cave like the wrong thing? The wrong one? Could avoid that one. So, bottom right. Then, no, not that one. I was wondering if any of the walls in here were destructible, but I don't know. Okay, let's try that theory. So we've come out here, we're gonna go in down here, and then in the bottom right cave. Maybe the cat runs off to a cave and you have to follow it. So bottom right takes me here. Now I'm gonna try going down into here straight away. Oh yeah, I should have known, it just sends me here. Oh! Don't get too mad. I can trigger that animation just by going back and forward. Okay. So I've been in here and it puts me here. And then I went in there and it took me to snakes, didn't it? I can't get up, can I? Oh, I almost can. Oh, it's so close. Is that solid? It is. Yes, I can get up. Okay, so we're up here. Okay, try this. Oh, that's different. Different cave, not snake cave. That's... individual snakes. Ah, quit it! No! It's stuck on me and just hurting me! How is that fair? Let's go back. Oh. Yeah, Gibbon's trying to make these connections between this Monster Panic thing and any Donkey Kong related thing. Admirable. Love it. Okay, let's beat up some bats. Take that. Ah! No, quit it. I can't do anything. Oh, it's just... what about if I do the direction cycling thing like the shark? Not helping at all. It just fell off eventually. Man, this is tough. Avoid the snake. I'm gonna save here. Avoid the snake. No, snake. Bad, bad, bad. Snake, bad. Go, 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 go. Yes. If you like my commentary, I'm an expert at commentary. Gon would fit right in with BC Kid, actually. I think they'd be good friends. They're both prehistoric. They both have big heads and like to smash things with the heads. Even this animation reminds me of... No! BC Kid even has a transformation where he kind of turns into a dinosaur thing. It's in Super BC Kid. I really ought to play more of those games, it's on my list. But then I keep buying more games in real life. And I preferentially play them instead of emulating old ones. For some reason. Two doors. What do I pick, chat? Left or right? Too bad, I'm going the left. Oh, wrong! So that leads to more snakes. That would be a heck of an annoyance if I wasn't using my little save states here. Wah! Wah. Take that. I'll teach you to steal my bird friends and eat them. I don't like that. I took too much damage. Okay. Nom 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 nom. Yes, that worked well. It ties him out just like flying though. Okay, so the cat got away and it went up. So, whoop, come back. Man, what a jumper. Okay, that's the sound of a cat being defeated. I'm up to hyena in Tokyo Jungle. In survival mode, you can unlock new... dang it! That was wrong. You unlock new animals by playing as other animals and finding... You know, it doesn't just happen automatically. There's like a special mission for each animal to find another specific animal, which then unlocks that. So for example, as a hyena, well, that's a bad example because they actually have two possible. Have I been in here before? I have not. This is a new cave. Yeah, they have two target animals. Oh, what? There was only one way out of that cave and it led to the snake cave. All right, let's go this way. Yeah, so as a hyena, you can either find a cheetah and, well, you have to take over the cheetah's territory and then you can place the cheetah. But then after doing that, you have the option of finding the boss bear and taking that out, and then you can place a bear. And the bear was too hard for me. I was playing for a while and then the bear killed me, so gotta start again. It's tough. But yeah, you know, it's the life cycle of an animal in that game. You eat, your hunger meter is always decreasing, so you always have to find more food. You have to avoid predators bigger than you, and you eventually find a mate, and you have to breed, and then you take control of the next generation of offspring and play as them, and they inherit abilities or stats, I guess, from their parents. Aha! There we go. Those damn snakes. This game's dastardly. Very sneaky. Digging a hole. What other digging games does it remind us of? There was this one mini game in a Magic School Bus game I had. It's not really the same thing though. And that's an impasse. Maybe it's a dead end. Aha. Excellent. Okay. Save here, because what if there's more snakes? Nope, just one exit. Okay. One exit, and... Cat, you're mine. Fight me like a cat. Oh no! Sorry, Gibbon, I just don't like Mode 7. I know you love it. Ooh, dig that background music. I like the mountains back there too. They look nice. Don't know if it's worth losing 2/3 of the screen for them, but... Yeah, I could have done without these sections. I mean, it may not be obvious, but the controls for the 2D sections are a little sticky, clumsy, not the best, but still, it's better than this. Ah, nuts. Given says it's fine if I pay out Mode 7, because this one is pretty lame. Well, to my eye, it's not that different from any other one I've seen. I mean, I mentioned Super Star Wars earlier. That's the one that probably reminds me of the most. I haven't actually played through Pilot Wings, but I think that might even look worse because of the distance it scales out to, because you're flying above it. I don't know. Ooh. Found a nice screenshot of the box, says Given, of the widescreen edition. This is Crazy Con, the grandstand LCD game. The widescreen edition, which is spelled 2Ks, it does refer to the Frankenstein's monster as Crazy Con himself. Wow, amazing. That's what I speculated when I saw what the game board looked like. Was that the biggest, bulkiest thing was supposed to be the gorilla. Yeah, so I guess the gorilla from Crazy Kong and Crazy Kong Jr., if you think that's canon, that's a licensed version of Donkey Kong Jr. Or unlicensed, I don't remember. But it was made by the same company. Yeah, so that gorilla, who you might consider separate to Donkey Kong Sr. Come on, I'm right here. Save. Okay, we can do this, people. So yeah, so that gorilla must have died and been reborn as a monster man. Monkey? Not monkey. Ape. I guess. Oops. Wow. I don't believe this. Oh, man. Okay, we got this. This time I won't be an idiot like I have the last two times. Oh, the jump button didn't go off. Come on, cat, you're mine. Your ass is mine. Yes, you heard me. I said ass. I think words I would never say. Okay, I'm not just gonna quit Simpsons all day. That would be lame of me. Come on, I got you before. I can do it again. And then save this time. Ah. No, come on. Yes. 1 second. Danger Mouse has left for some sleep. Enjoy. Yeah, no, I don't think that's what's happening, Given. I don't think the monkey slash cat is getting smaller as I get closer. I think it was just getting away from me as I didn't run as well. I don't know what I was doing wrong exactly, but... Ah! Darn it. Oh, did I win? Ah! That was interesting. Yes, take that. Man, cats are good at headbutts, apparently. Get out of it. Take that. No! I feel like this is the final battle. Come on, cat. Bobcat, whatever you are. I just gotta not get too angry. Yes! Mid-air stomp. Mid-air... whatever. I'm losing my words. Get me a drink. Oh, the bird was okay. That's nice. Oh, boy, oh. I wonder how many levels there are. Oh, bonus stage. Street Fighter 2 style. I forget if it's actually Street Fighter 2. What's the one where you beat up a car? Oh, I get it. He's sculpting a picture of himself. A statue. Yeah, that mid-air thing. Like, you just stop wherever you were when you win. And I don't think that's good. Very charming. That dance. Oh, I wanted the fish. The bag got it. Nice Borealis. Actually, it's not that great. Sorry, Aurora. You're supposed to just use the Aurora. I used the descriptor instead of the noun. Man, I'm not going well with my words right now. That's a kind of small polar bear. That was an amazing sprite. dancing. Did it summon a blizzard or was it just a passing blizzard? Okay, now I'm guessing I'm gonna have to beat up all these bears to get through something. A cave. Yep, looks like that's blocked. Yes. Let's do it. We can fight bears. Bear fighter. Gone's fought bears before. I forget the name of the bear. Is it just Kuma in Tekken 3? And there's a panda in other games, or the panda's an alternate costume of the bear. My Tekken lore is not strong. Okay, don't go down too far. Man, these things fight back. Gotta be careful about blizzards. I don't know how to avoid them though. I guess they're just timed, they just happen. You have to not be up here when they happen, otherwise you get blown away. Don't jump. Oh yeah, I didn't jump and I got blown anyway. Keep at it, let's do it. Take that. Yes, it did oppose when the blizzard came, so I assumed that it was making the blizzard happen, but I don't think that's the case. It's a pretty funny pose though, you gotta admit. Okay, I think I heard a noise indicating that the cave had been blown open. Yes. I do have a turn down a little too far, I think, but it's hard to change. Once I adjust it so that the same headphone, the same audio is going to my headphones and to OBS for the stream, I can't actually change it after I tell it to go to both places. It's like a kernel extension or something that I installed. Ooh, whoa, a killer whale. Nice. Guess I should use their real names. Orcas? Orca. It's one of those Azeroth Uluru situations, I think. Possibly. Ooh. I got all cold and frozen from being in the cold water for too long, I think. Or, as I discovered recently, I always knew that Mount McKinley was the tallest mountain in North America, the continent. But I was wrong. I wasn't wrong because it's the same mountain, but they renamed it at some point. So the information I was working on was a little out of date. And they now prefer the native name for the mountain, officially. Which now I can't remember what the name is. Denali? I think it was Denali. That bear is pain dancing. Is pain dancing a thing? I've not heard of that. A cave entrance. What do I do? Is there another orca? Aha! Quick, before I freeze to death. Yes. Cool. Oh boy, hope I don't have to fight that. Okay. Ah, I don't have to fight that. I have to dig. Watch out. Oh man. Oh man! Brutal. Oh, the ice is slippery and it's making me recoil off the far wall every time I break through something. Oh boy. Oh boy. Okay. Huh? Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, okay. Talking. Donkey Kong. Oh boy. Nah. No. Yeah, the tail whip's just faster, I think. These rocks are hurting me too much. Stop. Okay, so I think it can give me an indicator of where the next tunnel down is if I... Good. Yeah, if I open up a thing in the ceiling. Oh, okay. That's fine, but I actually just want to leave. I don't need that. It's not going to be at the end, is it? Should I save now? I feel like I'm going to die any minute, so I probably shouldn't. No. This is crazy. How much digging do I have to do? No. Ah! Save. I do wonder. I think that just took me back to the start, actually, out in the ocean. Which is a bit of a dick move, to be honest. That looks more right. Oh, I'm underwater again. Okay, before I freeze to death. Oh boy. No, don't tell me. Oh. Oh, he's gone all blue. Oh boy! Okay, I can't attack now. In fact, like, there we go. I think... Okay, well, I got out of that one, didn't I? Is this not the right way? Ah, here we go. Oh, that's the water surface. No, not here, not here. Okay, hopefully there's no penalty to my health for that. Whoa! The blizzard got me even in here. Weird. Oh, movement's so slow. So I can't attack while in that frozen ice thing, but I can escape it by doing the dance, which I triggered by tapping from side to side. See, he blows water out his nose when he jumps out. That's a fun detail. No. Okay. Okay, that's fine. Stop, please. It's difficult to move here. Okay, it's fine if you blame me that way. Don't read too much into that. Please, yes, please let that be it. Whoop. I hope that wasn't bad. I'll just check what's over here first. Let the blizzard pass. It hadn't passed. I do have a speed up button, by the way. Okay. No. Jump like that. Okay. There's nothing here. Let's go. Let's go fight some orcas. Hey Shamu, this one's for you. Actually, I'm kind of oppressing Shamu at this point. Just like SeaWorld. So, yeah, escaping those is probably not a matter of circling the D-pad, but just going back and forth like I was to escape the ice, I think is the way to escape that kind of thing. Uh-oh. Before I get frozen, I intentionally get myself blown out like that. Oof. Okay, just warm up a bit. Go. That's too slow. Swing. I'm going for that polar bear now. Oh no, 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 no. Tense animal combat. No. Tough bear. Okay, save there. And we'll hunt some more whales. Good, come to me. No, stop going away from me. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Whoa, that was close. How many whales are there? There's like three on top of each other. Whoa! They spiked me, man. They spiked me. Real good. Okay, fast falling doesn't do much good there since I have to mash to actually make progress. Come on. Freeze me and I can escape. Okay. Save here. And let's beat up some whales. Let's try it again. See if I can knock them all at once. Nope. Duh. Man, oh man. Tough whales. Tough crowd. I can't bash downwards because that gets me killed. Okay, headbutting is good. Let's just warm up a bit. Whew. Can you look up how many levels are in this game, Gibbon? I wonder if it's feasible to finish it all. I do like doing that. But is that a face on that iceberg? Tell me that's not a face right there. Uh-oh. That was close. Where are these damn whales, man? Oops. Of course I die. I'm trying to mash as fast as I can because this is getting long, this section. No, 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 no. I just wanted to warm up a little. I'm not sure how fun this mechanic is of getting frozen and getting blown around by the blizzard. Adds difficulty, sure. Yes, Arctic Zone, there's three more worlds after this. Three more chapters. Okay, head button time, that seems to work well. Nope. Oh, come on. Let's try the bitey. Thanks for looking that up, by the way. I don't know, I don't think I'll finish this, probably. Man, oh man. They really often need meats. My tasty meats. Okay. Let's try and sneak up on them instead. Not like that. Okay, what if I get frozen a little bit further away, then recover, and then dash in for a kill? They did it to me. They killed me. Okay, I'll go a little bit further away. Like here. Okay, good. Save. No, they're getting away! Oh, yep. So I hit him, but I did a downwards hit and fell to my death. Oh, finally. Okay. Blow me, Blizzard. Blow me. Blow me hard. Yes. Yes. Okay, now there's two exits. In the sea and up top. So I'll go for sea first. Now, is this familiar? Where are we? That's new. Okay, just for reference, gonna go up top this time, see where that takes us. I forget who I'm chasing, a polar bear? Yeah, a polar bear. I can't double jump when I'm in this cold state, it seems. Oh no! This game's brutal, man. Okay, good. Go, 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 go. Nah. Whew. Oh, yes. So the other way must have been a bonus thing. Good. Okay, this is fine. Oh, don't tell me. I knew it. All right. Let's get this over with, if we can. So at least we got to enjoy a bit of music in these stages. Oh, I'm right on his tail. Dope. Well, it's a decent game. If it's that long, even if it pads its difficulty out with that tedious, oh no, you got the wrong door, go back to the start thing. I believe Super Princess Peach might have done a bit of that as well, maybe. It's not really, like, great game design. It's like a substitute for good game design. Oh, come on. Stupid bear, no, don't get away. Yes, come back. Come on, no. I am holding up, I don't know if that really actually helps on it. I've let go of up. He seems to be going the same speed. But the bear got away. Now I start holding up again and I seem to get closer, so yeah. Now he's getting away again, even though I'm still holding up. Come on, bear. Give me my fish back. I found that fish fair and square just lying on the ice. I think Gone is a Donkey Kong Universe game. Are there any like headbutt boost button or something? So the headbutt, I feel like slows me down. I can headbutt, but the A button does nothing in this mode. L and R don't do anything seemingly. A is jump, but that's just to get over the icebergs. I don't know if that actually speeds you up. It could be that I'm missing some kind of trick to it, but the way I've done it so far is just to stay on their tail and hold up, and it works eventually. Yes, yes, yes. Oh, no, no, no. Ah, I wonder if I can headbutt through. Nope, can't headbutt through the ice things. Okay, I'm sure I can get do it this time. Yeah, see, it doesn't really change my speed at all. It's not helping me catch the bear, so I don't know the point of it. Or maybe it is helping me to stay close. Nope. Okay, let's just hold up. Oh, it's so close, come on! Ah! Oh, thank goodness. What now? Oh, the bear was taking fish to its parent, and I ate the fish with them. Happy, happy. Good year, very good year. Back in 64, before you were born. That's a Ruffles song. Neil Innes's very good Beatles pastiche parody band. So now we're in the swamp. Oh, what do you reckon? Let's do this one and then see how we feel. See if we should keep going. Oh, it's the butt-sniffing gorilla. Hilarious. Okay, so we haven't come across any conflict yet. Okay, the poses the animals do, that's amazing. Also, this gorilla looks kind of small. Yeah. The animals doing poses thing seems to be part of the humor, and I very much approve. It's nice. Ah! Crocodiles or alligators? Probably alligators, right? Looks like a South American jungle kind of thing. Gon doesn't really care where he is. He changes setting a lot, apparently. Goes all over the world. Yeah, stunlocked you, bitch. I mean, sorry, I shouldn't swear. I was using lingo. Whoa! That was bad. Oh, drop kick. Could be India, so it's given. Oh yeah, I guess there aren't gorillas in South America, are there? No, this dang dirty ape. I love it. Does India have gorillas? Probably would have known this stuff when I was a kid. My animal encyclopedias and stuff. Let's save here. Beating two gorillas. Seems Gon gets tired if you do too many attacks that use up his energy. And the jaw bite seems to be one of them. Oh. Let's see how far I can get with this glide. I am losing height. It is limited. Now, does my health reset when I enter a new area? It doesn't. The background music's still going. I should have figured that out by this point. Oh no, it's another one of these. At least that's the feeling I get. Multiple caves to go in. So no, India doesn't have gorillas, so it must be Central Africa. One of the damp, swampy parts of Africa. Come on, tell me that's not a cave. Can I not enter there? Apparently not. Well, it was just a bonus area, so I'll just go around the way I came. Okay, that works. Just falling from too high, you fall off the bottom of the screen there. I'll just swim if I can. Try not to fall down. Just to cover this distance. Storm effects are kind of atmospheric. No pun intended. Nice moody background, the lightning. So, how far do I have to go? Nope. Bad. I wasted all our time by trying to speed up the process and just falling off the bottom of the screen. Oh, I was adjusting my grip on the controller, damn it. Okay. Anyway, yeah, check out the bottles. Very funny stuff. Well, not always funny. There's a few, like, outright comedy songs, but some of the more comedic ones were just reworked from some of Ennis's early material. Really, the strength of them is in seeming so much like they're the Beatles, but with new songs. I guess they're slightly humorous. Not always, though. Okay, we made it. Ooh, tough stuff. Oh, come on! Don't tell me I have to fight those birds. No. Okay, I made it. He wouldn't go in when I was pressing up, but then he did. Go figure. Now what? Another one? This is weird. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know how to proceed. I've been in two bonus areas now. And there's crocodiles everywhere. But there isn't another exit here, so it's not like fighting them is gonna do anything. And that's not getting any deeper. Instantly killing me. Oh, okay. So I get the sound. It goes weird when I speed it up. And also, he shot to the top of the screen. Let's try fighting these then. So much for that. Oh, I'm hurting them more than they're hurting me. No, the other way around. This is tough. I'm off the top of the screen, not too far. Water physics are weird, actually. If I'm attacking, then I'm like zipping around. It's like I have a little burst of momentum when I hit the jump button underwater, which rapidly goes away. But if I attack while I'm doing that, then it seems to conserve it for much longer. Maybe I could use that to get around faster. And I'm not making much progress on these things, and they're just hurting me. So, Gibbon, you looked up, like, a list of levels. I don't know if you could just tell me how to beat this one. Oh. Hey, Tony! Welcome to the party. I'm playing Gone for the Super Famicom. I see something up there. How do I get up there? Yeah. Fair enough if you've got commitments. This isn't an obligation for anybody except Gibbon. This stream. He's the one committed to showing up all the time. There are no walkthroughs, okay. Well, the game's not too hard. Just requires a bit of common sense and not being an idiot, so once I figured out I could jump up to a higher platform, I got through to the next place, so thanks for looking. But, yeah. I suppose we'd have to buy some guidebooks from Japan or something if we wanted to find out more. Oh, I can go a bit deeper on this water. Maybe. Oh, not too deep. Yep, I died. Okay, so I'm here. Seems like the only way to go. Oh, this is the previous one. Okay, just go through here. Okay. So yeah, I don't know, there's not much more to this game than meets the eye, Tony. It's a series of sort of vignettes in the life of Gon. So I've been through a rocky canyon, the waterfall zone with caves, the Arctic, and now I'm in a swamp. Did I miss anything? And you just sort of fight animals that you come across, and yeah, just that's all there is to it. Gon's simple life, but he's happy. Again, I'm assuming that it's a male, this little Gon creature. I don't think there's any episodes of the manga where he finds a mate, although even then it might not be clear. Oh, this is tough. There must be a platform around here somewhere. Huh. So that attack boost underwater shot me up, and then I was able to double jump after that. Maybe I'll use that to get out of here. See, this looks like it should be a platform to land on, but it's not. But again, that's an exploit that I'm using there, so... Okay, I'm stumped. Oh, here's the thing! Cool. That's when I was giving up. Save. Okay, what now? See, I don't know if I like this kind of game design where you just sort of have to roam around until you... Okay, now that I have things to fight, it's, you know, it's a different story. There's something to do. Oh yeah. Tony, those gorillas, they walk along, they scratch their butt, then they sniff their finger that was in their butt, and then they fall over going, "Ugh!" It's pretty great. It's cutting edge humor. You won't see games doing that these days. This game was, I want to say 1993, but I'm probably wrong. It was on the Super Famicom, so sometime in that system's life. Look it up. Hope I killed enough gorillas. Yep, okay. I don't think there's any blocked zones in this world. So, just getting through it. Do, 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 do. Pow, pow. Uh-oh, I'm getting angry. That's bad. When Gon gets angry, Tony, he destroys the world, essentially. Like, he's invincible. Nothing hurts him or phases him. Well, he gets phased easily. He gets annoyed. If he gets too annoyed, he unleashes all his wild power on the Earth itself and just blows it up. Well, he splits it in two, a bit like Arale from Dr. Slump. I believe that's something that she does. So, essentially, gag character. And that music means that... Oh, now I have a dashing headbutt. Did I have that before? Is that something I can only do when I'm mad? I guess I haven't tried dashing attacks too much. I heard that gorilla. Did I finish it off or not? I heard it. I heard another one. Yes. And I think I put the game in stereo, so... I think I just had a little stereo moment. Coming from my left. Another one? How many bonus tokens are there in this level? This should be at AGDQ. I'm sure there's exploits I don't know about. But it looks amazing. It really looks nice, this game. I'm impressed with that aspect. Okay, that closed behind me. Holy hell! Okay, the drums have stopped. That means, oh, he's mad. He's mad. Oh, I died. See, I fell down too far in the water, and this is what happens, Tony. Wonder if that happens in the manga at any point. Holy crap! Snake! I tried to bite it just as it was biting me, but it's bigger. It's tough. Just gotta time my headbutt jumps. Who developed this game? It was Tose, Tose. The company who did Super Princess Peach and Legendary Starfy and like a billion other games that they sometimes are uncredited on or sometimes just did quietly. One of the Game & Watch galleries, I think. They did a bunch of games. But they're famous. Oh, that was a hit, I think. There was an anime adaptation in 2012. Yes, that is true. Aired right before Tamagotchi, so I caught a bit of it, says Tony. Obviously, one of Tony's main interests is the Tamagotchi franchise. So if it was adjacent to that, then yeah. Interesting. So what can you tell me about that anime, Tony? Who are the main characters? What I know of it is that it was a 3D, like CG animated one, right? I believe. Maybe wrong. And all the characters are voiced, which is completely unlike the manga, where there are no words spoken, no sound effects, noises represented on screen, on page, any of that kind of thing. So anything that does have speech seems to be missing the point of Gon, I think. But who knows? And especially if it had some kind of story. Gon's just about the wild animal antics of Gon the crazy dinosaur. Oh, I'm getting mad. Ah. Oh, no. Yeah, there was another 3DS game tying into, I believe, tying into that particular show. Did I save after I caught it in that loop? Oh, I'm back in the loop, so that's good. Nope. Come on, loop. Let me loop you. Yes, loop me. Loop me. I want to catch you in a pattern. Yeah, good enough. Let's just save after every hit now. Why not? Yeah, so the game on the 3DS, I think it's called Gon Baku 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 something something. I forget. It was in that video as well. And then I looked up a little Let's Play of it. It's kind of a much more traditional 2D side scroller than this is, with like pickups and stuff. You could maybe even call this a cinematic platformer, because there are no sort of gimmicks or HUD or collectibles. It's just you and your environment. Gon jumps pretty high though, so I don't know. Yes. Tony says he doesn't remember it very much, and it was cancelled really fast for an anime. That's unfortunate. But it was CGI, yes. Curse you, snake. I'm not good on the timing here. I think my best chance is to get it in a pattern like I did. This reminds me of Conker's Pocket Tales. The lag on my attack meant that I couldn't get it off properly before the snake struck me. Ah, oh, the pain. It's painful. Man, I've been doing this for what, an hour and a half. Should I continue to last two worlds after this, or should I call it? What do you guys think? I don't particularly have anything else to do today, so... Ah! Just gotta time it. No! 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 No, man. No. I don't think my jaw attack is gonna work. My call. Don't leave it up to me. I can't be trusted. If. Game's pretty, but not that exciting. Yeah, you'd rather be researching LCD games, wouldn't you? I know I would. Yeah, maybe I'll stop after this and we'll leave the rest of the mystery for the viewer to find out for themselves. Yeah, it's pretty exciting though. But, I mean, I can't be the only one documenting this online, so I don't think it's that valuable to do that, per se. Maybe I'll finish this level, do a quick search, and see if anyone has documented it. Done a full playthrough. I mean, there's no walkthroughs written anywhere, apparently. Nah! Oh, nice one. That's it, I think. I'm glad I got the final hit with the falling headbutt. That was beautiful. Hooray! I beat the big snake. And Gon swims away. Ah, bonus round. Of course, I got a bunch of little heads, didn't I? What do I do? Jump on the crocodiles? Alligators? African... There's crocodiles in Africa. Ah, there's a crocodile icon appearing up there. I wonder what that gives me. Seriously, there's no like extra lives or maybe it's continues. Maybe I'm getting extra continues. Oof. Hooray. There is a complete no death playthrough in 50 minutes on YouTube. Oh boy. How about you go watch that instead of me watching me do it, because I'm not really good at this game. And I've kind of run out of things to say, so let's call it there. We'll see what the next situation is, just because content. I'd like to see that, and then I'll go watch that playthrough you're talking about. And you can too. I'm up in the mountains. 50 minutes. I've been going for twice that. I'm still two levels away. Okay, well, that's it then. Yeah, thanks for showing up. Sorry you didn't get to see much, Tony. Yeah, Gon's pretty good. Oh, that's nice. Idle animation. Yeah, let's watch that. But yeah, it's a weird little duty that he showed up in Tekken, but this game is really interesting and different, you know? So, I don't know. Go watch that playthrough. yeah. And check out the manga too. Maybe if I have some spare cash, I'll get it next time I'm flicking through it in the comic shop. So, yeah. Oh, and sorry, while I got you here, Tony, go upload the podcast and I'll play Tempo. Otherwise, I will not play Tempo. So that's my weekly reminder for you to upload the podcast. Okay. See you next week, friends. Yes.